Hello everyone. I noticed that my Black+Decker box fan had been running quite slow, and there seems to be no problem with its motor, and the contacts appear to be in order. So I suspected that the capacitor might be already worn out, so I decided to cut it off. The rating of the capacitor is 1 microfarad for 50 volts. And I cut it off from this portion. This is my Kiritsu Qmate 2012 RA, now set to capacitor tester function. I will use that to test my old capacitor, rated at 1 microfarad with a tolerance of plus or minus 5%. That plus or minus 5% tolerance amounts to 0.95 up to 1.05 microfarad. Let us see if this capacitor is still within that tolerance range. The digital multimeter is able to test and measure the capacitance without having to discharge the capacitor, but I'm just being consistent by shorting the terminals first to remove any possible residual charge. I'm getting a reading of 0.871 microfarad, and that is well below the 0.95 microfarad lower limit for this capacitor, and that means this old capacitor really needs to be replaced now. And this is the new capacitor that I'm going to replace it with. It's also rated 1 microfarad plus or minus 5%, and again shorting the terminals to remove any residual charge. I'm getting a reading of 0.999 microfarad, which is virtually 1.0 microfarad. So this brand new replacement capacitor is a good unit, and I will use this to replace the old one. For this capacitor replacement, I'll also do a crimp connection like I did with my other electric fan that had a capacitor replacement. I'm going to use my new engineer Nijisaurus screw extracting pliers, which is high leverage design and equipped with a crimper, and see how good this crimper is. The crimp action produced by this Nijisaurus engineer screw extracting pliers with crimper is actually very good. It produces a clean crimp, tight and solid. It's also very neat. No damage to the insulator at all. when I opened this box fan, I wondered what kind of part of the fan this one is. I have not seen this kind of part in any of my stand fans. So when I opened it, I noticed that there is a movable thing there. It's a metallic, solid metallic cylinder that sits in between the two contacts, which is in turn connected to this one, these two terminals here. So it seems to me that this solid metallic cylinder acts as a bridge between these two surfaces. It completes the circuit. So since it's moving around, if it is in this position, there is no flow of current. Whereas if it is in this position, there is a flow of current, a continuity. And then I remembered that the box fan, if you turn it upside down, the fan will turn off. It will only run when it is in an upright position. And now I know why. It is due to this gravity switch. Alright, moment of truth. Black+Decker box fan with new 1 microfarad capacitor. Fan speed number 1. It looks fine. Let's see fan speed 2. There is a notable increase in fan speed, which did not manifest before when it was still using the old capacitor. Let's see fan speed number 3. There is a much more notable increase in fan speed, and as far as I recall, this is the normal speed of the electric fan when it was brand new on fan speed number 3. So I can conclude that the solution to the problem of this particular box fan of mine was simply a replacement of its worn out capacitor. Remember the part before that I showed you, the one that I call the gravity switch? I'll turn this fan upside down and let's see what will happen. As you can see, the fan automatically turned off. That's because the contacts in the gravity switch was removed. Putting back the fan in its normal upright position, it resumed working because in the upright position, the small cylindrical solid metallic object there completed the circuit between the two contacts. Actually, I don't know what is the proper term for that part there. I just call it gravity switch for lack of a better term. I hope this video has provided you with some information about possible problem and solution to a slow turning electric fan. Thank you for watching.